Hello, it's Wednesday, it's 9 o'clock. I'm Chloe Tilley, welcome to the programme. Could universal credit put claimants who live with abusive partners at additional risk? Well, that's the conclusion of a cross-party committee of MPs who warn that the system is turning the clock back to the 1950s by allowing abusers to take control of family finances. Well, we're going to be speaking to the chair of that committee. Thousands of children in the UK are forced to share beds with their siblings or sleep on the floor, according to new figures from a charity. And we're going to be finding out how bed poverty affects children. And he has entertained weary plane travellers and gone viral with his flight safety demonstration video. But now the music has stopped for flight attendant Mikey Tonko. We'll be finding out why just before 10 o'clock. Hello and welcome to the programme. We're live until 11 o'clock this morning. Now, have you struggled to afford to buy a bed or other essentials for your children? Or has the introduction of universal credit impacted on the way your family finances are controlled? We want to hear your experiences this morning on those and all of the stories that we're talking about. You can use the hashtag VictoriaLive. Now, if you're emailing and you're happy for us to contact you, maybe you want to take part in the programme, do please include your phone number in your message. And if you do text, you're going to be charged at the standard network rate. Our top news story today. Jeremy Corbyn has issued an apology over sharing platforms in the past with people who hold anti-Semitic views. It follows claims that speakers at an event hosted by the Labour leader on Holocaust Memorial Day in 2010 compared Israeli actions in Gaza to the mass killing of the Jews in the Holocaust. Well, our political guru is Norman Smith. We can speak to him now. Norman, who exactly did Jeremy Corbyn appear with? Thank you, Carol. Hello, it's Wednesday, it's 10 o'clock. I'm Chloe Tilley. Thousands of children in the UK don't have their own bed, according to new figures from a charity. They either sleep in a bed with siblings or on a floor. We'll hear from one mum who shared a bed with her daughter for 4 years and also from the charity itself. At least 49 women have been killed by their stalkers, partners or exes after reporting them to the police, according to new figures. Victims are calling for a new register, similar to the sex offenders list, which would help track offenders. We'll speak to the father of Alice Ruggles, who was murdered by her ex-boyfriend, despite reporting him to the police for stalking her. Later today, a Conservative-run council will vote on scaling back the services it provides to the bare minimum because of severe financial difficulties. It needs to save up to £70 million, that's 15% of its budget, by next March. We'll be speaking to the council leader just after 10:30. Now, if you do live in that area, do get in touch with us. If you've been affected by Northamptonshire's funding crisis, or indeed have vulnerable children who are supported by the council who could now be at risk. All of the ways of contacting us are on the screen now. Lots of you getting in touch with us about the stories we're talking about this morning. A little bit earlier on, we were talking about universal credit being paid as a single payment. And a committee of MPs has said that can actually put women at risk if they're in a domestic abusive relationship. We've got one email here from Bren, who's got in touch to say, this happened to my mum, who had five children under five in the 1960s. Social Security was paid by gyro. My dad used to gamble it away and we'd have to go without basics of food and clothes. Liz on Facebook said, I used to work for the DWP and was told off by my manager for giving an obviously abused woman a helpline number and told, is she giving the same excuse why she's not turning up to sign on? She was locked up in her own house and black and blue, that is why. And also, after the sport, in the next few minutes, we're going to be talking about sharing a bed. This charity saying that thousands of young children are having to share a bed with siblings or sleep on the floor. We've had one text here saying, on the subject of children sharing or not having a bed, as a child in 1940, we slept head to toe and there was absolutely no benefit. And another text said, I shared a bed with my two brothers. It didn't do us any harm. These days you can buy a bed in good condition from your local newspaper adverts at a very small price. Your thoughts welcome on all of the stories we're talking about this morning. You can use the hashtag VictoriaLive. If you're emailing, if you're happy for us to contact you, maybe you want to take part in the programme, do please include your phone number in your message. And if you do text, you're going to be charged at the standard network rate. Right, let's get some sport now with Chris. Now, it's being claimed that thousands of children in Britain don't have a bed of their own. The charity Buttle UK says many of them are forced to share beds with their siblings or even sleep on the floor because their parents can't afford to buy them separate beds. Buttle says it's provided more than 13,000 beds to children over the last 5 years and is now written to MPs and councils in the UK's most deprived areas calling for action. Well, it's something we'll be discussing in a moment. But first, BBC Yorkshire's Anna Crossley has met families who have been helped with beds. Now, if you're in the Yorkshire area, you can see more on this story on BBC Look North tonight at 6:30. Well, coming up, Now, at least 49 women have been killed by their stalkers, their partners or exes after reporting them to the police. Well, that's according to Freedom of Information requests submitted to 45 police forces. In a moment, we'll speak to the father of one of those victims. Well, campaigners are calling for a change in the law to protect victims of stalking by making it easier for police to track perpetrators. Alice Ruggles was murdered by her ex-partner in October 2016. First, here is Alice's story as it was told to the online magazine Broadly, part of Vice. Now, understandably, her story is upsetting. It lasts just over 5 minutes. Well, let's bring you some breaking news now. The former English Defence League leader Tommy Robinson has been freed on bail by the Court of Appeal after winning a challenge against a finding of contempt of court. Well, our correspondent Tom Burridge is at the Court of Appeal for us now. Tom, tell us the latest. Now, as we mentioned earlier on, a Conservative-run council is warning it may have to cut basic services after imposing emergency spending controls for the second time in 6 months. Northamptonshire County Council needs to save more than £60 million by next March and will decide today whether it should limit the work it does to a bare minimum. Well, we can speak in a moment to the leader, the Conservative leader of that council. He's just making his way to join us well. BBC Newsroom Live is coming up next. Thank you for your company today. Have a great day. I'll see you again in the morning.